आई एम प्रोफेसर वी एस बांदल, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, आर बी अटल आर्ट साइंस एंड कॉमर्स कॉलेज, गेवराई. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्पीक ऑन कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स. द मीनिंग ऑफ द कम्युनिकेशन इज द एबिलिटी टू कम्युनिकेट इज द प्राइमरी फैक्टर दैट डिस्टिंग्विशेस बीइंग फ्रॉम एनिमल्स. And it is the ability to communicate well that distinguishes one individual from another. The another definition and meaning of the communication is the fact is that apart from the basic necessities, one needs to be equipped with habits for good communication skills, as only this will make a happy and successful social being. The word communication comes from Latin verb communicare, which means to impart, to participate, or to share. The meaning of the communication is to share ideas, information, message to the society or the individuals. Effective communication is the important to all of us in every sphere of our lives. Be it our career or our relationship, it means that unless and until we have effective communication, we cannot exchange our ideas, information, thoughts and messages. Then there should be a better language is equal to better communication is equal to confidence. Means the sender should be full confidence to communicate whatever he is going to share, whatever he is going to express to the other person or the audience. Communicating confidently is the secret of living happy and successful life. We can say that the cause of the every quarrel lies under the word. The definition, we are going to see the definition of communication. Communication is commonly defined as the imparting or interchange of thoughts, opinions, information by speech, writing or signs. Means with the help of speech we can communicate whatever we have to say, we have to give information, we have to give messages. Then there is another type of communication, that is writing. We can send the message with the written or signs. In non-verbal communication we can use the signs and symbols to communicate whatever the sender has to express or to say. The features of communication. The first feature of the communication, that it is meaning based. Means whatever we are going to communicate, there should be a list meaning. Then the another say feature of the communication is should be conventional. According to the conventional, the term conventional, we should use the communication for the conventional purpose also. It is appropriate, it should be appropriate, as well as it should be intra-actional and it is structured. Ingredients of communication. Social contact of two or more persons, sender and receiver. Once again we are going to throw light upon the sender and receiver. Means there should be two person or more than two persons, one whom is going to express, one whom is going to say something, and the other should be the receiver. Means at least two persons are needed for the sake of communication. Transmission of some message. The sender is going to transmit any kind of message forever, maybe individual, academic or personal, religious, social, economical, financial, moral. And there should be a common medium. Common medium means the language should be the same, the medium should be the common to understand the audience. The common language, once again the point is that the common language means that which the language we are going to use for communication should be common, that our audience, the receiver, should understand, should follow the language. A common frame of reference. What type of reference we use, the receiver or the audience should understand. And interpretation of the message, the meaning of the message, the interpretation of the message should be clear. And at the same time, the last point is that the feedback is more important. Unless and until we have feedback, we cannot understand what message we have given to the receiver and what meaning of the receiver or what type of interpretation the receiver has taken from the message. Then there are types of communication. Mainly there are two types of communication: verbal communication and non-verbal communication. If we see the definition of verbal communication, we can say it is the use of words to share information with the other people. It can therefore include both spoken and written communication. However, many people use the term to describe only spoken communication. The verbal elements of communication is all about the words that you choose and how they are heard and interpreted. Then there is another type of communication, and that is non-verbal communication. If we see the definition of non-verbal communication with the example, we can understand people may nod their heads vigorously when they saying yes to emphasize that they agree with the other person. The another example, a shrug of the shoulders and sad expression when saying I am fine, thanks, may actually are not fine at all. Then oral communication. In oral communication, we use the words, language. In written communication, what type of language we use for our communication and what type of meaning or what type of interpretation the receiver has taken, it is more important. Then in non-verbal communication, we have personal appearance, postures, gesture, facial expression, eye contact, and space distancing. Means with the help of these signs, we can communicate with the help of non-verbal way. Then we are going to see the interview, where the communication is more important. The word interview is derived from interview, meaning sight between. It is the meeting between two persons with a specific person. It means the meeting requires two persons for specific person, specific purpose. It demands direct and dynamic interaction. It involves an assessment of one participant by another. In interview, both the persons should understand one another. Unless and until take place the better communication between the interviewer and the interviewee. Features of an interview. There is a definite purpose. Means every interview has a definite purpose. Both the parties need to prepare for the event. For example, the interviewee has to prepare before going to interview the topic, the syllabus, the content, the purpose, and the interviewer also has to prepare whatever the topic he has to be given, whatever the questions he has to ask the interviewee. They are prearranged, means the interviews are prearranged according to the convenience of both interviewer and interviewee. There are at least two participants in the event, means any interview cannot take place unless and until there are two participants. There is a clear exchange of information. It means both interviewer and interviewee have to exchange clearly the informations, the message, the purpose. Then we are going to see the structure of the interview. Opening. In introduction, the interviewee has to introduce himself with the help of verbal communication. He has to give information about his resume, biodata, educational qualification, experience, training, whatever he has given. And this is the helpful for the interviewee to make clear information to the interviewer. Statement of the purpose. The interviewee must clearly express the statement about himself or about the question asked by the interviewer, making other person comfortable. It is the responsibility of the interviewer that the interviewee should be comfortable at the time of communication, at the time of interview, or what type of questions he is going to ask the interviewee. Creating an atmosphere of relaxed, open-minded approach. In an interview, both of them should be relaxed, open-minded approach. One can share his ideas, thoughts, and interviewee can ask the question to the interviewer. If he is not going to understand the question, if he is not going to understand the meaning of the question. Main body. Aim at the exchange of information. Aim at the exchange of information means the information the interview or the interviewer is going to say should be clear. Keeping the discussion to the point, both of them should be discuss with the point. They should not go away from the point. Listen attentively and patiently. The interviewee must listen whatever the interviewer is going to say, and according to the his view, he must express whatever he has to say. Keep eye to eye contact. This is more important, because the interviewer will understand that the interviewee has full confidence and he is expressing his ideas clearly. Give carefully thought out answers. The interviewee must answer carefully. He should not give fake answers or false answers or improper information. Make sure to the cover of agenda. Both of them have to cover the agenda of the meeting. Take care that the interruptions, if any, are polite. Whenever the interview is going on, sometimes there may be interruptions of technical, or some persons may be disturbed, but both of them should remain polite. Seek clarification if required. Both of them, if they require some clarification, both of them can ask one another. They should be free to ask one another. Closing. Summing up the discussion. At the same time, while the interview is going on, they should sum up with their discussion, describing the action decided upon. There should be give more importance to the action, whatever the action they require. Avoiding a hurried or abrupt ending. They should not close the meeting or the interview before they wanted to express clearly. Closing on a positive note. At the end of the interview, they should be positive, and they should be close the interview with a positive note. Exchange feeling of gratitude and thankfulness. Both of them should express gratitude about one another. Guidelines for the interview. Be prepared for the interview. Means the interview must prepare before going to interview. Have a presentable appearance. The interview must have the presentable appearance when he is going to face the interview. Make effective use of the body language. The interview can use the body language to make effective communication rather than the verbal communication. Answer completely and correctly. This is more important thing, that the interviewee must answer completely and correctly. Never try to bluff. This is also most important thing. Be polite. The interviewee must be polite, and he से मस्ट लिसन केयरफुली व्हाट द इंटरव्यूअर इज गोइंग टू से अवॉइड टॉकिंग टू मच द इंटरव्यू मस्ट आंसर क्लियरली एंड इन से एप्रोप्रिएट मैनर ही शुड नॉट टॉक मच मोर अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट अवॉइड क्रिटिसिजम द इंटरव्यू डू नॉट ट्राई टू क्रिटिसाइज एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू थैंक द इंटरव्यूअर्स एट द एंड ऑफ द मीटिंग और बिफोर द मीटिंग ही शुड बी से एक्सप्रेस थैंक्स टू द इंटरव्यूअर्स बिकॉज दे आर गिविंग टू चांस और माइट बी सिलेक्ट टू द इंटरव्यू डू नॉट हेजिटेट टू आस्क क्वेश्चंस इफ द इंटरव्यू हैज सम प्रॉब्लम्स ही कैन आस्क द क्वेश्चंस टू द इंटरव्यूअर्स दे हैव द राइट ऑफ द सेम देन वी आर गोइंग टू सी द पब्लिक स्पीकिंग In public speaking, all epoch-making revolutionary events have been produced not by the written word but by the spoken word. It means if the epoch-making revolutionary have written many kinds of literature but the literature doesn't affect directly, there should be the speaker or orator and one whom is going to throw light upon the written, say, literature. With the help of verbal communication. Then preparing for the speech. If you are going to speech, you have to first consider whatever he has to speech, when he is going to speak, where he is going to speak, why he is going to speak, and who is going to speak, and in how or in what manner he is going to speak. If we say study all these points, then definitely our speech will be have a better communication. Preparing for the speech, think of the purpose. Means our speech should be inform, persuade, entertain to meet and get on our audience. Means every successful speaker has to take all kinds of cares that whatever is the information he is going to say or in a public speech he is going to persuade of the audience or he is going to entertain the audience or he is going to meet and he is getting ride on our audience. Think of your audience. This is the duty of the speaker or the orator where they are now means he has to must learn the status of the audience, their expectations, what kind of expectations are of the society or of the audience, and according to the expectations he should prepare his speech. He should think upon practical needs, whatever the practical needs are there in the society of the audience, he must speak on practical needs. He must think of the intellectual needs, whatever the intellectual needs are there in the society or in the audience. Their personal needs, sometimes the speaker must consider the personal needs of the audience. Putting the speech together. The better, if the speaker has to give the best speech, he should have the content, ordering, jokes, quotations, and anecdotes, and he must write his points of the speech before he is going to speak. Delivering the speech. At the time of delivering the speech, he must be confident. Talking to his audience, dealing with interruptions and questions. Sometimes the audience may ask the question. Sometimes the audience may make interruptions. At the same time, he should be silent, he should be clear, he should be control the audience using his voice. And nowadays there are so many types of communication aids, and so with the help of these communication aids or these medias, he should be used for the delivering the speech. Thank you.